Hello and welcome. Did you see the lights of Lichfield? Not the street lights or traffic lights, but the cathedral lit up with a glorious display of moving images, its walls as giant display screens. Actually, I think it's become an annual event around the end of August, and this year it was simply entitled Science. I was fortunate enough to go along and feel that it's a spectacle worth sharing. So I shall put some of my pictures on screen as I talk this morning. After the collect for the week, some verses from Psalm 98, in which the psalmist visualises the whole creation voicing its praise to the Creator. Now let's pray. Almighty God, you search us and know us. May we rely on you in strength and rest on you in weakness, now and in all our days, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Psalm 98, verses 4 to 9. Shout for joy to the Lord, all the earth. Burst into jubilant song with music. Make music to the Lord with the harp and the sound of singing. With trumpets and the blast of the ram's horn, shout for joy before the Lord, the King. Let the sea resound and everything in it, the world and all who live in it. Let the rivers clap their hands. Let the mountains sing together for joy. Let them sing before the Lord, for he comes to judge the earth. He will judge the world in righteousness and the peoples with equity. The idea that religion and science are opposed to one another has always seemed absurd to me, but it's a view that has got fixed in the minds and assumptions of very many people. We have to keep on finding ways to express how the two complement each other. Very often, science and theology either use different language for the same thing, or else are trying to answer different questions. Scientific questions tend to be of how life is, how things happen. Religious questions are of deeper purpose and meaning, the why questions. Both scientists and people of faith, and of course the very many who are both, are united in approaching the natural world with a sense of awe and wonder. Whether at the microscopic structures of matter, or the stupendous secrets of the universe, or simply the trees and flowers around us. The Lichfield lights attempted to express that awe and wonder and do so by the bucket load. They communicated at the level of experience, not as reasoned argument. They brought together through sight and sound not only science and belief, but artistic creativity with technological innovation, the latest technology in an ancient building. The walls, archways and vaults of the medieval nave and choir became giant screens for high-tech images projected in constant motion. Scientific notation, diagrams of cell structures and the particulate nature of matter, periodic tables and much more cascaded over ancient walls in vibrant blues and greens and reds. Personally, I would have liked a guidebook to tell me more about what I was actually seeing, but the experience was everything, and with it, the time to think and digest and inwardly respond. It was in the chancel that I had my thoughts as sets of symbols and diagrams rose up the apsidal east end of the cathedral, high above the high altar. What struck me was that the scientific notations, in a sense, contain the whole expression of life, the component parts, the chemical composition, the inner structures of living beings, and all was rising up to heaven. Here was a representation of creation's praise, just as the psalmist had said, shout for joy to the Lord, all the earth. animate life, and indeed inanimate creation too, brings its praise through its very being, in the very place where the choir would normally be singing, all giving glory to the Creator. I had two more challenging thoughts as well. The first in the context of science and religion debates. These scientific formulas I was looking at map out life on their own terms, answering the questions, the very important questions that scientists ask. But of course, they are not the whole of life as life is experienced. In fact, they say very little about what it is to be alive. Of course, without them, our understanding of any organism would be woefully limited. But we should not be dragooned into accepting that this is all there is to be said about life. Second, in the context of the climate crisis, as I imagine the whole of creation rising up towards heaven, I also imagined a great black cloud blocking the way, or a thick smog enveloping it all. Human action degrades the planet, wipes out whole species of God's glorious design, and sets us on a course of self-destruction. The human calling to articulate the praises of creation must be matched by true care for that creation. Lift the smog, so all of life can live as God has purposed it to do.
Hallelujah.
Let us pray. First, a prayer for scientists and scientific endeavour. Almighty God, Creator and Lord of all, we praise you for the knowledge given to us to search out and harness the hidden forces of nature. Bless the endeavours of those who carry out the work of science in its many forms. Grant with increasing knowledge, increasing wisdom, that they may use their discoveries and inventions for the welfare of all humanity, the good of the planet, and the glory of your name. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And a prayer for the environment. Creator God, you made all things, and all you made was very good. Show us how to respect the fragile balance of life. Guide by your wisdom those who have power to care for or to destroy the environment, that by the decisions they make, life may be cherished and a good and fruitful earth be preserved for all future generations. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And the Lord's Prayer. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. And may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all forevermore. Amen.